After building the transmission, these cables, what you see here, this is a ground that's grounded on the cable front, and this is a ground that's grounded on the engine back over there. So in this case, I have filled up the transmission till here a little bit more. When I fill it up, I fill it actually twice. What I did, I fill it up to there, then I make it on the side, then I make it from my side here, I make it full back, I make it full front, tilt it, and then I fill it up again, and I bring it again up to here to be full of oil inside. Then I fill it up back here, I bleed the clutch release bearing here, this is the pipe, and then I bleed also the two forks that has here. So I already check from the Allen bolt here, there is also from down and from where you fill it up. Now this will be for the adaptation. I'm waiting one plate, that this plate, I'm gonna remove this, you're gonna bolt it here, you're gonna demonstrate the push plate that has the car. That means you're gonna push the release bearing full inside and you're gonna stay there. So when you make the adaptation, you're gonna be with four bolts, two here, two there. When you're gonna make the adaptation, you're gonna see when it's releasing the clutch and when it's engaged in the clutch inside. Plus, you're gonna give me the space with the same plate. You're gonna have an adapter here to be able to turn the transmission to make the adaptation, because it's not letting you to start the engine. You're gonna tell me, okay, why you're not starting? Why you're not turning with the hand? Why not turning with the hand? Because it's not consistent. I mean, you're turning like this, and then you have to make it again. And if when it starts shifting, to put, let's say, neutral first, neutral reverse, neutral second, neutral third, you have to be, you have some speed, let us say, to make this. It's not letting you starting the engine if you don't make the adaptation of the transmission, because it does know if it's two gears engaged at the same time or something. Anyhow, that's the plan to finish with adaptation. Most probably the ground we're gonna remove from here. Maybe I'm gonna bolt a bolt, or I'm gonna put somewhere else on the transmission. Again, it's not gonna be perfect, but when we put it everything, we have to repeat it again. At least we can give us a chance to warm up the oil inside, and because the new synchro, they are grabbing. It's you can stop, let us say, the output shaft. Also this one here for the four-wheel drive. But when you're turning it, it's very hard, let us say, to turn this, because the two synchro hub, they're brand new. So if it's a little bit close, it's grabbing the gear and it's turning at the same time. So this is the solution what we found. And let's continue with the rest. I need to check again the bleeding, when it's gonna work the pump, when it's gonna build some pressure the accumulator. I already bleed it, I pass, I don't know, 3 liters of oil, 3-4 liters. I was having a full bucket with a pump, with a closed system, and it was coming always fluid out. I believe we're gonna be fine. My priority was to go oil everywhere, we have lubrication everywhere, to don't have air here, don't have air on the lines, don't have air on the clutch release bearing, to be everything nice and full. So all the ground cables being connected, all the cables from the engine, it's been connected, but not the engine, obviously. I don't care, actually, because I'm not planning to start the engine. If it passes from the adaptation, I'm happy. What's happening? When start making the adaptation, he wants to go, let us say, neutral reverse, neutral first, neutral second, neutral third. If it is, let us say, in one gear and not going to be engaged inside, what's happening? It's going to engage and then it's pushing it back. Then it's going again. From this one, it's reading where is each fork. There is here, there is here, there is here, and showing where it's located each fork. So when it's not spinning the transmission, sometimes it's like the manual car that you're trying to put, let's say, you can put the first gear, for example, but you cannot put the third gear because they're not turning the gears inside. So this is what's happening with this transmission. And since it's not letting you to start the engine, for safety reasons probably, because as I said, you can have two gears engaged at the same time. You can have one gear, let's say, here, you can have one gear here, and you don't know what's gonna happen. So the principle here is to fix the adapter, fix the push plate here, because you want to see when you're gonna be engaged, disengaged probably. I'm gonna get the measurement from the original clutch with the old push plate, actually. just I want to see how much is supposed to be inside. Leave a space here in the middle, connect this handle, turn it slowly, and make the adaptation. That's it. And then imagine, let's say, to put on the car everything, and then to need again adaptation. This is gonna be terrible. We already tried before. This is the third time that I'm removing the transmission from the engine, because the adaptation failed. It was coming neutral reverse, okay, neutral first, okay, neutral second, was stuck on the second gear, and then it was going neutral second all the time, and then it was saying to you adaptation failed. Then again it was going to, I was start moving the wheels, and then it went, let us say, from neutral reverse, neutral first, neutral second, neutral third, and then it was stuck on the third gear. So like that we can spend I don't know, months trying to make the adaptation. And the solution is remove it everything again, once again, I get used to it now, fix a plate, fix this one, and crank it. That's the story. Thank you very much. When I finish, you're gonna see a test drive of this car. Yeah. Nice. That's the story. One more thing that I forget to mention. If the stupid software for the adaptation, it was going one by one, that means, let's say, you put neutral reverse and then neutral again, and then it passed, let's say, the reverse, and then neutral first, and then passed the first gear, and then neutral second, and then pass again the second, this will gonna be fine. But in this case, it has to pass through all 8 gears. That means it has to go from reverse to number 1, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th gear, and when it's passed from all of them, then the adaptation is successful. If it's stuck in one gear, it failed the adaptation, it has to start again from the beginning. That's why it's difficult. Yeah. Good luck.